Good day. In this video, we're going to look at notation and the meaning of that notation in calculus, mainly in grade 12. At the end of the video, you should be able to understand all this ugly writing that you see on this graph. And if you understand it, you can answer your level 3 and 4 questions in paper 1 and 2. At the end of the video, take a screenshot of this sketch and the writing so that you can look at it calmly and see if you understand what all of this means. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to work with a cubic function, his first derivative and his second derivative. I assume then that you understand your cubic function. This is a f of x equals to x to the power of 3, doesn't matter what the rest of the letters and numbers there are. It's a positive cubic function. It means it lies with this shape. We will not use the y-axis in this video. It's mainly the x-axis and how the graph lies on it and how the derivatives is found from that again. I also assume that you looked at the video sketching a cubic function. If you look at a cubic function, that and that will be your stationary points, maximum stationary point, minimum stationary point. Those three points there will be your x-intercepts. You make y zero. And here you'll find your point of inflection. It is in the middle between that stationary point and that stationary point. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to use exactly the same shape all the time. First notation, f of x is the graph himself. If you see the question, f of x equals to 0, it means find the x values where the graph cuts the x-axis or where y equals to 0. That's inside those three red circles. The next notation, f of x is bigger than 0, means find the x values where the graph is above the x-axis, above y equals to naught, everywhere where you see the green lines, excluding the circles. The next one, f of x is smaller than 0, means finding the x values where the graph is under the x-axis, under y equals to 0. That is the red part there and the red part there, excluding the circles again. Something we're not going to cover in this video, but I'm just mentioning it. I put a star there. If they say, where is f of x smaller than equal to 0? It means find the x values where the graph is on or under the x-axis. So it's everywhere where you see the red now. So it's that point and everything here, that point, everything underneath here, including that point also. If they ask, where is f of x bigger than equal to 0? It means find the x values where the graph is on or above the x-axis. Everywhere where you see this green line now, and including those three points. It is a friend of this answer. Please stop the video and read through this and try and understand what is exactly meant by each one of these notations. The next notation we're going to look at is f accent of x. That gives us the gradient of the original graph at that x value. So, f accent of x equals to 0 gives us the x values where the gradient is 0. That's at our stationary points. It gives us the x of the stationary points. That's over there and over there is where f accent x is equal to 0, f accent x is equal to 0. Next we wrote, f accent of x is bigger than 0, where is the first derivative positive? It gives you the x values where the gradient is positive, the graph is increasing, and the gradient of the tangents is positive. That is all the x values where the graph is green now, excluding that point, excluding that point. So everywhere where you see the green line, those x values are being spoken about. The next notation we must know is f accent of x is smaller than 0. Where is the derivative negative? Where is the gradient negative? Gives us the x values where the gradient is negative, the graph is decreasing, the gradient of the tangents are negative. That means they're talking about all the x values where this red line is, excluding that point and that point at the turning points. Please stop the video and see if you understand all the notations we wrote on this graph. Lastly, we're going to look at the second derivative. F double accent x gives us the second derivative.
f direct x tells us about the concave up or concave down of our graph. This graph is concave up over here, excluding that point. And this graph is concave down over here, excluding that point. First part of the notation then. Our second derivative equal to zero gives you the x of the point of inflection. The graph is not concave up or concave down at this x value. So that gives us the x value over there, in the middle between that stationary point and that stationary point. Stop the video and get your brain around this, please. Your second derivative is bigger than zero or positive, shows for which x values the graph is concave up. Say I made a little U here, I didn't put arrows in any one of the two sides. So that is this part of the graph where you see the green, excluding the point of inflection. That is where the graph is concave up, and that's how we write it. The second derivative is bigger than zero. Please stop the video and get your brain around this. This is really third level thinking until your brain grasps it. Next, the notation says, where is the second derivative smaller than zero, or the second derivative is negative? It shows for which x values the graph is concave down. I made it upside down U. No arrows at the moment. So it's from that point all the way to negative infinity. This graph is concave down, or the second derivative is smaller than zero. So the graph is concave down everywhere from the point of inflection left, excluding that x value. I said in the beginning here, at the point of inflection, it is not concave up or down. It changes at that x value. Please stop the video and get your brain around how the second derivative influences some of our calculations later. Now we can put all this information on one sketch. Something that's not part of the grade 12 syllabus is that when you go to university, whatever you learned here will keep on happening on a fourth degree and fifth degree function. In other words, we will have concave, more concave ups and more concave downs, more gradients that change, derivatives, everything. But it's going to be as easy as this. Let's talk about this sketch quickly. So this graph is positive everywhere where the graph is green. And all the green writing tells us that the graph is positive. The graph is negative everywhere where the graph is red, and the writing in red tells us so. Everywhere where the graph is green now, the gradient is positive, and the writing in green tells us so. Everywhere where the graph is now red, the gradient is negative, and the red writing tells us so. Everywhere where the graph is now green, the graph is concave up, and the green writing tells us so. Everywhere where the graph is red now, the graph is concave down, and the red writing tells us so. Please stop the video and take a screenshot of this if you want to summarize it for your level 3 and 4 questions in paper 1 and 2. Now here is something extra where you can check yourself. Stop the video and check yourself. Please indicate whether you liked or disliked the video and subscribe to the channel. If you run into a calculus problem, grade 12 level, that you have problem solving, you may send a clear WhatsApp photo of your problem to this number and a clear WhatsApp photo of where you tried it. Then we will try and help you and send back an answer as soon as possible for free. Enjoy calculus.